Let's try to give you a winter look.
Before a big show, there's a lot of work to do, from costumes.
Either of these, any of these.
To getting the music right.
Or it sounds like this.
Yeah,
To even setting up your own lighting.
Unless you want that starker one.
Especially if you're Frances Binder and James Moore. The two make up the whole of Seal Cut Theater, and they're about to put on their latest production.
Our mission is that we want theater that sticks, what sticks to your ribs. Like, you go home and you have something to talk about. Hello? I can't talk now.
Moore and Binder came to Vermont from Portland, Oregon 2 years ago.
It's difficult.
But?
I don't. Lots of the language.
Frances is from here, a Castleton State College alum, and that connection has helped the two break into the local theater scene.
I think the population of Vermont is more willing to accept all kinds of art.
Behind the scenes, you'll find Castleton's Harry McInerney. He heads the theater department at the school, another connection that helps keep smaller companies like this going.
We get to showcase that our alumni are out there producing good theater, doing good work, and making it available to everybody.
What might be some reasons for pursuit of higher education?
For James and Frances, it's about the intricacies.
A lot of interrupting and backing up and restating things.
You don't do that.
Forget things? Everybody does that.
It's also about taking theater off the big stage to a smaller audience, one they're hoping will embrace them here in Vermont.
But then what am I doing
here?
When nobody wants me and nobody tells me anything and I sit there in the corner, in the back, and what in the world are you talking about?
We like to think that we offer something that's a little bit different than maybe some of the other works that they would see normally.
Steel Cut's production of Oleana hits the Flynn Center's whole theater Friday. Beyond that, they say, who knows what they'll tackle next.
There are people out there, people who came here to know something they didn't know.
In Burlington, Jill Glavin, News Channel 5.